Unless you configure a firewall, your server will accept connection attempts on any port, even ports you did not intend to leave open. This leaves your server exposed to the entire internet. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly what that means and how to lock down your server safely with a simple firewall in just a few minutes. Let's start out with a demo. I'm going to use the netcat command to try to connect to my remote VPS server on port 999. And you can see immediately that it says connection refused. What this means is my server received the connection attempt, aka it saw the traffic coming to port 999, but because there's no application listening behind that port, it sent back a message saying essentially that there's nothing here. You can think of each port like a door, and without a firewall, all the doors are unlocked by default, but a firewall helps us lock every door except the ones we want open, such as port 80 and 443 for our website and port 22 for remote logins. So let's set up a firewall on our VPS server, and we're going to use something called UFW to do this, which stands for uncomplicated firewall. And if you've been following along on this series, it's probably already installed. You could check that with the which UFW command. And as you can see, it's installed in this directory. Now, if you did want to install it, you can do apt install UFW, but it's going to say that that's already installed, so there's nothing to do. Okay, so let's first check the status of the firewall. So we can do that with UFW status. And as you can see, it's inactive. So let's go ahead and give it our first firewall rule. So if you didn't know, even with this remote droplet console that we're accessing, this is using port 22, which is the default SSH port to log into the server. And we want to, before enabling the firewall, we want to allow traffic over port 22 so we don't get locked out. So in order to do this, we can do UFW allow. And technically you can type in 22, which is the SSH port, like I said, but you would also have to do TCP. And I'm not even going to get into this. There's a shortcut command that we can use, which is open SSH, which takes care of all of this for us. So we don't have to do all those technical details. So if you type UFW allow open SSH, hit enter, it says that the rules were updated for both IPv4 and IPv6. Now, if we do UFW enable, to enable the actual firewall, and as it says here, this may disrupt existing SSH connections, but it won't because we're going to allow that rule. Proceed with operation, type Y, hit enter. Now it says firewall is active and enabled on system startup. So let's do a UFW status again. And you can see that OpenSSH has some rules here. It's allowing that. But if we do a UFW status verbose, now you can see a little bit more detail. So it says the default rule is to deny incoming traffic, which is exactly what we want. We're going to allow outgoing traffic, but specifically the rules that we're applying are port 22 over the TCP protocol. We're going to allow those to come into our server from anywhere. And same thing, we didn't talk about IPv6 yet. We will in a future video, but that's also allowed. Same thing, port 22. Now, what's really cool, and I mean, I guess it depends on how you look at it, but this firewall, if we refresh our website, has blocked access to our website. You could see it's just spinning here. If we open up a new tab and go to our website, lulanta.org, same thing. Port 80 and port 443 HTTP and HTTPS ports are blocked because of the firewall rule that we just added. So what we want to do is go back and add those as exceptions to the firewall. We want those ports to be allowed to be accessed. So just like before, we can do UFW allow. And again, you can do 80/TCP or you know, like 443/TCP, but there's another shortcut that you can type in, which is nginx full. And if we do that, if we do a UFW status verbose, you can now see that we are allowing port 22, port 80, and port 443. And you, maybe in the background, you can just see that that page actually refreshed. It allowed traffic to access that website. And we could just confirm that again with a refresh. Perfect. Everything's working just as we expect it now that we open those ports to our website. Now, for good measure, let's test out port 999 again. So let's open up that command prompt on my local computer here. And we'll try the same exact netcat lookup on port 999. And this time the door is locked. Our server doesn't respond at all. And after 5 seconds, the connection attempt times out. That's our firewall silently dropping the request which is exactly what we want. But even with a firewall, there's still one big risk. SSH logins using passwords. Anyone on the internet can try to guess your password over and over again using what's called a brute force attack. If your password's weak, they might actually get in. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to fix that by creating a safer user and using key-based logins so that password guessing is impossible.